Well, good afternoon students, welcome back to online mathematics class. So in the last class we have solved up to the 7th problem. So let us continue with the 8th one. The question is, if the sum of n terms of an AP is Pn plus Qn square, where P and Q are constants, find the common difference. So he has given Sn and we will have to find d value. See here, in order to find d value, we have to first calculate a1 and a2. So here Sn, which is equals to, what has he given? Pn plus Qn square. Pn plus Qn square. Pn plus Qn square. Now go for n equal to 1. For n equal to 1, for n equal to 1, you get S1, which is equals to P into 1 plus Q into 1 square. So overall S1, which is equals to P plus Q. What is S1? See here, if you consider the series A1 plus A2 plus A3 plus A4 plus so on plus an, so this is nothing but sum of the first n terms of an AP. So here a1 is nothing but s1, or s1 is nothing but a1. Sum of first term, it is going to be s1. So a1 plus a2 will be sum of first two terms, and then a1 plus a2 plus a3 will be sum of the first three terms. So here s1 can be written as a1. So this is equals to a1. I call this as equation number 1. Now for n equal to 2, for n which is equals to 2, for n equal to 2, then we get S2, which is equals to P into 2 plus Q into 2 square. Q into 2 square. Now S2, which is equals to 2P plus 2 square, it is 4, 4 into Q, it is 4Q. Then, so this is S2, but what is S2 here? Sum of the first two terms. S2 is nothing but A1 plus A2, but S2, which is equals to A1 plus A2, which is equals to A1 plus A2. What is S2? It is 2P plus 4Q. 2P plus 4Q, which is equals to A1. A1 is nothing but P plus Q. It is P plus Q plus A2, write it as it is. Now, take these two terms to the left hand side. So, what do we get? 2P minus P plus 4Q, 4Q minus Q. This is going to be A2. So this implies A2, which is equals to 2P minus P will be P, then 4Q minus Q will be 3Q. So P plus 3Q, we have got A2, and here you have A1. So the common difference is going to be A2 minus A1. Therefore, common difference, therefore common difference, therefore common difference d is equals to a2 minus a1, a2 minus a1, then d, which is equals to a2, it is p plus 3q, it is p plus 3q, then minus a1. So it is minus P minus Q, minus P, then minus Q. So D, which is equals to, see here, plus P, minus P get cancelled. So 3Q minus Q will be 2Q. It is 2Q. So this is the required common difference. So this is all about the 8th one. Write down this, then we'll move on to the 9th problem. Well, the 9th problem, it is The sums of n terms of two APs are in the ratio 5n plus 4 is to 9n plus 6. Find the ratio of their 18th term. So here he is talking about the ratios of the sum of two APs, sum of n terms of two APs, and the ratio it is 5n plus 4 is to 9n plus 6, and we will have to find the ratio of their 18th terms. So let me write the given information. So it is n by 2 given, n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d, then whole divided by, this is the sum of n terms of the first AP. So then for the second AP, you need to take the first term as capital A and the common difference as capital D. So to distinguish, so here n by 2, then it is 2a plus n minus 1 into capital D. See here, the sums of n terms of two APs are in the ratio. So these are the Sn, sum to n terms of the two APs are in the ratio 5n plus 4 divided by 9n plus 6. 5n plus 4 divided by 9n plus 6. So now let us simplify this. Now n by 2 and n by 2 get cancels. Write the remaining term, 2a plus n minus 1 into d, then whole divided by, so here it is 2a plus n minus 1 into capital D, which is equals to 5n plus 4 divided by 9n plus 6. So now here in the left hand side, I'll be taking 2 common in the numerator as well as in the denominator. Let us take 2 common. So you get a plus, here you don't have 2. If you are taking 2 common, it will be divided by. Andre en aagthare idu, n minus 1 divided by 2 into d aagthare, then whole divided by, this becomes 2 outside, then it is a plus n minus 1 by 2 into capital D, which is equals to 5n plus 4 divided by 9n plus 6. So now 2 get cancels, and we need the ratio of their 18th terms. See here, a n which is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now we need the 18th term. That means replace n by 18. A 18 equal to a plus 18 minus 1 will be 17. That means we get a plus 17d. Overall, here we will have to calculate a plus 17d divided by a plus capital A plus 17 into capital D. That we will have to find. So now, see here, a plus n minus 1 by 2 into small d, then divided by capital A plus n minus 1 by 2 into capital D. This is equals to 5n plus 4 divided by 9n plus 6. Divided by 9n plus 6. Call this as equation number 1. So now you need the ratio of 18th term. So that means a plus, this has to become 17d, and here also a plus 17d. Overall, now we have to go for the substitution. So n minus 1 by 2 equal to 17. Therefore n minus 1 by 2 is equals to 17. So idu n aagbekre namage 17 aagbeku, idunu 17 aagbeku, adike en madivi, n minus 1 by 2 andre 17 tagondivi, 2 ikade tagori. So n minus 1 equal to 34, and then n which is equals to 35. So we have got the value of n. So now substitute n equal to 35 in equation number 1. So equation 1 becomes, see here, a plus
n it is 35. 35 minus 1 it is 34. 34 by 2 will be 17. So we get 17d. Then similarly divided by a plus 17d. This is equals to, so now replace n by 35. 5 into 35 plus 4, then whole divided by 9 into 35 plus 6. Then, so a plus 17d, then here a plus 17d, this is equals to 5 into 35 will be 175. So 175 plus 4 divided by, this becomes so 315 plus 6, and then overall a plus 17d divided by a plus 17d, which is equals to how much you get? 179 divided by 321. Therefore, at the end you will have to write in words. Therefore, the ratio of their 18th terms, it is 179:321. That you will have to write. So this is all about the 9th problem. Well, the 10th problem it is, if the sum of first p terms of an AP is equal to the sum of the first q terms, then find the sum of the first p plus q terms. So let us go ahead with the given information. So here given SP, which is equals to SQ, sum of first p terms is equal to the sum of first q terms, and then we will have to find S of P plus Q. So to get this, we need the value of A and D. So let us simplify this now. This implies, so Sn, n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. N is nothing but P here. So P by 2 into the bracket 2a plus P minus 1 into d, which is equals to SQ, that is Q by 2 into the bracket n by 2, really n andre Q adu 2a plus Q minus 1 into d. So now 2 get cancels here, multiply P with these two terms and Q with these two terms, so you get 2ap plus P and then P minus 1 into d, which is equals to, so here you get 2aq plus q into q minus 1 d. Now I take these two terms to the left hand side. So here we will be writing 2ap minus 2aq. These two I have written. Then plus in these two terms we have d common, and if you take this to the left hand side it becomes minus. So overall I'll be writing P into P minus 1, then minus Q into Q minus 1, and then you have D common, which is equals to 0. Any doubt in this? So now 2AP minus 2AQ plus multiply P with these two terms. Overall you get P square minus P minus Q square minus into minus, it is plus Q into D, which is equals to 0. Then in these two we have 2a common, so let us take 2a outside. You get P minus Q plus here, so P square minus Q square, P square minus Q square can be written as P plus Q into P minus Q. See here, P square minus Q square is nothing but P plus Q into P minus Q. Then here in these two terms I take minus common. If you take minus common, again we get P minus Q. So I take minus out, you get P minus Q, then D, this is equals to 0. Then Again in these two terms, again in this term and in this we have P minus Q common. So 2A, or else we'll write one more step. We'll write this as it is, 2A into P minus Q. Into P minus Q as it is plus. So here you can take P minus Q common. So it is P minus Q outside. Then what do we get now inside? P plus Q minus 1. And then close the bracket, write D which is equals to 0. Then, so now in this term and in the second term, we can take P minus Q common. So if we take P minus Q outside, then we are left out with 2A plus P plus Q minus 1 into D which is equals to 0. So in these two terms we have taken P minus Q common. Then so here you have to equate this with a 0 and second term with a 0, but P minus Q cannot be equal to 0 here. But P minus Q is not equal to 0, therefore 2A plus P plus Q minus 1 into D which is equals to 0. So now we will have to go for find the sum of the first P plus Q terms. S P plus Q which is equals to SN form N by 2 and P plus Q divided by 2 into the bracket 2A plus N minus 1 into D. N andre P plus Q adre ile. So N minus 1 into D. So now SP plus Q, this is equals to P plus Q divided by 2. Then 2A plus P plus Q minus 1 into D is nothing but 0. So here into 0, 0 into anything is always 0. Therefore SP plus Q which is equals to 0. So this is the required answer. So note down this and then we'll continue the 11th problem in the tomorrow's class.